One of the most important qualities of the radioactive ion beam facility is the beams it can provide. And Isolde, I'd say, is one of the best in the world because it can provide some of the most intense beams, most exotic, and also the purity is important, and the fact that it can provide post-accelerated radioactive beams.
From biomedical applications to nuclear astrophysics, using a complex infrastructure and cutting-edge experiments, the men and women of Isolde push forward our understanding of the universe. This is Low Energy Physics at Isolde. To understand our universe, scientists need to understand the elements and in turn the atoms it is made from.
It's a little bit like when you go to school, you learn maths, you know, and you use that afterwards to do other things with. Without that basic knowledge, you wouldn't be able to do your research, for instance, when you're much later in your career, because you don't have that build up that pyramid of knowledge, of basic knowledge underneath you. That's a little bit what we do at Isolde. You have this, all this basic understanding, all the understanding of the elements, the isotopes, and this exploration of the nuclear chart. And this is then afterwards useful in very many different fields.
Scientists at Isolde use radioactive beams from the CERN accelerator chain, but unlike in the LHC, they aren't accelerated to higher energies.
Well, we don't need high energy beams, because all we need to do is to get the ions that we take out of the target in time to the experiment. In time, that means within their half-life, before they decay. That's what we do at Isolde. So we don't need the very high energy as they have at LHC, where they are actually focusing on collisions. The collisions we have at Isolde, they take place in the target, and for those collisions, we need as much protons as we can. Therefore, Isolde takes about half of all the protons produced at CERN from the CERN PS booster.
These low-energy radioactive beams allow nuclear physicists to study the properties of the nucleus, right at the very center of these atoms.
When we talk about low-energy physics, we talk about nuclear spectroscopy. And that explains us how the nucleus is shaped and what it looks like. Basically, it gives us a better understanding of what the world around us, in terms of building blocks of elements, is made out of.
And of course, compared to LHC, we are not expecting to have any groundbreaking discovery. I don't know, a nucleus shaped like a triangle. But nonetheless, all the research we are doing will bring insight, and in the future, probably in 100 years or even more, they will look back at our results and they will realize how important they are.
But as technology has developed, scientists can go further and further into their understanding of these elements. They can fill in the blanks which can have direct uses in our world.
All of the knowledge that comes out of Isolde is used in society in all different sort of ways. So we have a large scale of physics at Isolde. It goes from material science, where they unravel very complex processes using Isolde beams to understand better, you know, the working of the semiconductors, so we can improve semiconductors in terms of making better electronics, more reliable and faster, such as computers and LED technology. No, but can also be in medical applications. But we also look at much, much larger scale questions, such as what are the stars made out of? How does it work? What are the processes inside? And how are all the elements created in the stars and what happens in the universe?
Studying the different isotopes means scientists can get a basic understanding of what the elements are, what they do, how they behave, and every form they might exist in.
And so for us, what we want to do is we want to probe the really exotic nuclei and measure their properties and see if they are what nuclear theory predict.
For my PhD thesis, I'm interested in the nuclear structure of magnesium-34. And hopefully after this, I'll move to another nucleus, maybe in the same region of magnesium. But you see, it's like Pokemon. In the end, you have to catch them all.
We can take these radioactive nuclei and we choose the particular element and the particular isotope we want to study. And we do that by using lasers and magnets to separate them. And then we can send them to a whole variety of different experiments at Isolde.
The properties of many previously unexplored isotopes have been studied actually already at Isolde. But this every time brings new questions as well. So the success of Isolde is actually that we get more and more experiments coming towards us. So there's a higher demand every time, and there's still a very bright future for Isolde, even for the low energy part of it.